Hello, I'm Dr. Lee. Welcome to the Practical Pain Management. In this video clip, I'm going to introduce the anatomy and clinical significance of the coracohumeral ligament. This video is a long story, so I'm going to split into two parts. Coracohumeral ligament is a broad ligament and connect between coracoid process and humerus. It arises from the lateral part of the coracoid process and passes obliquely downward and laterally to the front of the greater tubercle of the humerus and inserts into lesser and greater tubercle of the humerus. Numerous pictures are describing the coracohumeral ligament, but most of them describe the humeral attachment site, but do not describe the coracoid attachment site. I'm going to introduce one wonderful article describing the coracohumeral ligament. The authors are describing more details about the coracohumeral ligament and correspond well to my research. The left image helps you understand the shoulder joint orientation. Focus on the acromion, coracoid process, scapular spine, and long head of bicep tendon. The right shoulder image shows the right scapula shown from the lateral side. In this image, the right scapular spine was cut and muscular tissue of supraspinatus and subscapularis was carefully removed. Let me describe more detail. Here is greater tubercle, coracoid process, cut section of scapular spine. The orange circle indicates the intramuscular tendon of the supraspinatus, and yellow circle indicates the intramuscular tendon of subscapularis. This structure is long head of biceps tendon. The coracohumeral ligament originated from the coracoid process and extend over the rotator cuff interval, cranial part of subscapularis, caudal part of supraspinatus. It inserts into greater tubercle and lesser tubercle. For better understanding, I'm going to split into three parts of coracohumeral ligament: central, middle, and peripheral part of coracohumeral ligament. The central part of coracohumeral ligament is the area of attachment to the coracoid process. On the coronal image, it belongs to the site to the medial to lateral edge of coracoid process. On the sagittal image, the central coracohumeral ligament is located to the posterior inferior to the coracoid process and anterior superior to the glenoid. The middle part of a coracohumeral ligament is the coracohumeral ligament area between the lateral edge of a coracoid process and greater tubercle's anterior border. On the coronal image, it belongs to the site to the outer side of the lateral edge of a coracoid process and middle of humerus head. On the sagittal image, the middle coracohumeral ligament is located to the posterior inferior to the coracoid process and anterior superficial to the biceps tendon. The peripheral part of a coracohumeral ligament is a ligament at the greater tubercle and lateral one-third of humerus head. On the coronal image, it belongs to the site to the outer one-third of humerus head and greater tubercle. On the sagittal image, peripheral coracohumeral ligament is very flat and located superficial to the biceps tendon. Once again, coracohumeral ligament will be described as central, middle, peripheral part on coronal, sagittal and axial images. This macroscopic sagittal section of the humerus joint shows similar structure with the MRI sagittal scan. Figure A corresponds to the central coracohumeral ligament, and figure B corresponds to middle coracohumeral ligament. Let's close look at the anatomy in section A. Humerus head, coracoid process, acromion, supraspinatus muscle and tendon, subscapularis tendon and muscle, long head of biceps brachii tendon. The blue mapped area is the coracohumeral ligament extended broadly. Coracohumeral ligament covers the anterior surface of scapularis and made a fold to the anterior below the long head of biceps brachii tendon. Let's match section A with the sagittal T2 weighted image. Humerus head, coracoid process, acromion, supraspinatus muscle and tendon, subscapularis muscle and tendon, long head of biceps tendon, coracohumeral ligament. Let's close look at the anatomy in section B. H is humerus head, SSP is suprascapular muscle and tendon, long head biceps tendon. Blue mapped area is the coracohumeral ligament, and this coracohumeral ligament is shallow and flat. Most of the doctors are familiar with this anatomy. This is the histology of a coracohumeral ligament of a specimen comparable sagittal section A, long head biceps tendon, and coracohumeral ligament. The ligament consists of irregular and sparse fibers. It's not typical true ligamentous structures. These illustrations demonstrate the extension of the ligament. Acromion, coracoid process, humerus, supraspinatus, subscapularis, and this area is coracohumeral ligament. The right image is the schematic illustration of the inferior surface of a coracoid process. Left image helps you understand the orientation. Unlike most of you imagined, coracohumeral ligament is not attached to the lateral edge of coracoid process. The gray area mapped area is the typical attachment of a coracoid ligament on the right image. Coracohumeral ligament attaches to the anterior, lateral, and posterior undersurface of coracoid process. In the next video, I'm going to share normal MRI anatomy and pathology findings and ultrasound guided intervention. Please stay tuned. See you next video. Thank you for your attention.